Hey, Russ here with bishopswest.com. I recorded a video a couple days ago about how to use the new sampler in Bitwig Studio as a wavetable synth. This is something that Bitwig put out in one of their tutorial videos for the new synth, and so I wanted to explore it a little bit more, but I don't think I quite went far enough. So I felt kind of bad, and I wanted to just do kind of a follow-up video to explain what I'm talking about. So what I've done is I've taken what I would consider a real wavetable synth called Z3TA+2, and the reason I say it's a real one is because it was designed to use wavetables in here as the source signal. And so then you take it through the traditional filtering, you mess with your ADSR, you've got your LFO to control, you know, different parameters, and you've got your mod matrix down here, and you can even set it up with an ARP. So I would say this is a fairly underrated but really powerful synth, and it's been something that I've been using for years, and it's just fun to play around with and goof off with. So point of all that is, well, how would I do using the sampler what I can do already in Z3TA+2? So I'm going to load up this Vintage Pulse 1. That's what the wave looks like in this wavetable. That's what it sounds like. I'm actually going to take it up just that much, just so you can hear what it sounds like. Okay, and that's not, I don't have any filters, I don't have any oscillators, ADSR, I have none of that set up, no effects or anything. This is just the raw waveform coming through. So far, it's pretty easy to do the same thing using sampler. So what I can do is even go and take from the wavetables that come included with the Zeta. I found the same one, it's a different name. It's called Silver Square. But I'm going to do the same thing that I did in the last video and drag that in again over here so it creates the sampler when I drag it in. Okay, get rid of that. You can get rid of this for right now. And so if I play, well, I haven't done anything. Remember, just kind of as a quick review, to use this as a wavetable synth, what we said was first choose cycles, right? And then choose the snowflake to freeze it on just this one, and now, and click on that, and when I play the note, sounds remarkably similar to what we had in Z3TA+2. A little bit different color. It's not over here, I'm talking about the tone, right? But essentially, you can tell that it's kind of built from the same sample. Okay, so next step, that's great that I can do that, but in Z3TA+2, I've got my filters over here. So can we do that with the sampler? Yes, we've still got filters here. We're missing the other thing with Z3TA+2, and you know, this is probably very similar for pretty much any other wavetable synth that you would work with. Serum keeps popping to mind because I was looking at that recently with some friends of mine. But this one has two filters, and you can kind of go back and forth between the different filters. Choose if you want to use parallel or dual. I won't go into all that now. But my point being is that you only have the one filter section down here, and that's what you're stuck with. You can't switch back and forth. On the other hand, it is automatable. It's still very powerful, but it's just missing that. The other thing is that it does have this key tracking, filter key track, which is, I like that for me. It's a good thing to do. And I won't go into that right now because I want to keep this short. But let's see what else. So we've got your ADSR. You can do the same thing down here. You've got your basic one for the pitch. And then you've got all the different ones that you can use, the envelope generators to control other parameters, whatever it is you want to control. We can achieve the same thing in here using a modulator, the ADSR modulator. We've got the LFOs. We can do the same thing, add LFOs over here. This is kind of fun because you can add sign and then add different kinds of signs. And maybe you want it to sync 16th notes, and you can control how much. So for example, if you set this up down in your mod matrix to control the cutoff, that's pretty fun to do, and I've played with that a lot. But so we can do the same thing with our mods over here, you know, add whatever LFOs you want to do, and then use that to control whatever parameters you want to do. And then of course we've got perform. Well, let's go back here. So the other thing is that you can use up to 6 different wavetables, which is just a crazy amount. With the sampler, you've just got the one. Again, we're coming at it from the different perspective though. With Bitwig Studio, you can use what Bitwig Studio provides to get around this, and that's what makes it so powerful, I think. So in this case, maybe I would add instrument layer. So I could have several instruments all together and then just adjust the different levels and panning, which is exactly what I would have done in Z3TA+2. So I think doing that, we can kind of get around that limitation. The other thing that you might want to use is the XY, the instrument XY, I think it's called, XY instrument mod, where you can put 4 and then control which one with the X and Y parameters. And then maybe even modulate that, so you're going back and forth between the wavetables. So that's like I'm saying, the whole point is that you're able to get around these limitations with Bitwig Studio. The place where I think it falls short though is the fun part of a wavetable synth is when I'm playing with this, I've got a whole bunch of stuff where I can actually modify that wave too. So so there's all kinds of different things that you can do to modify that wave, whereas down here you're stuck with whatever sample you've got in there. So that's fine because you can always go and choose all kinds of different samples, right? But you don't have the flexibility where you can adjust that sample and modify it, twist it, distort it, destroy it, whatever you want to do. You have to stick with whatever you have here. Now granted, you can take, this is interesting by the way, because it's exactly the same waveform, but just a bunch of them together. You can take, you know, different sections. But if there's something more complex, like, what's a good example? Well, let's see what the snare does. Just depending on where you put your start and cutoff points, that can adjust the sound of the wave. So you can do it that way, but again, you can't really twist and distort and destroy the wavetable like you can in, I'm sure, pretty much any other wavetable synth. So back to my original question, should you be using the sampler as a wavetable synth? Yes, if you just need something really fast, but if you want to really get into the sound design aspects of it and really tweak it in minute detail, then I would say probably no, this isn't the way to do it. Go and find your dedicated wavetable synth and use that. On the other hand, there are a lot of different things that you can do with this too. It's kind of a toss-up, but for that reason, that's why I'm going to say the answer is no. It's up to you though. Let me know what you think down in the comments below. It's always fun hearing from you guys, and I look forward to that every time I put up a new video. So thanks for watching, and I will talk to you next time.